Syracuse fans looking for tickets outside. It's too late. Ready to go with our second semifinal of the 2001 AT&T Big East Championship. 14th ranked Syracuse taking on Pittsburgh. The winner gets Boston College in tomorrow night's championship game. The champions of the East handled Seton Hall 75-48 in our first semifinal. Welcome back. Courtside of the Garden, Mike Tirico, Len Elmore. The winner here will try to become the first team ever to win the Big East Championship, playing all four nights of the tournament. Pittsburgh's the Cinderella story, though. Like Seton Hall, if they win, they're a win from the NCAA automatic bid. They're not getting in at large. Everyone asking how and why with Pittsburgh. You're the expert. We turn to you.
Any description of the Pittsburgh Panthers has to begin with Ricardo Greer. His will, his emotion, the intensity that he brings to the game for the Panthers. Now, Pittsburgh has the classical makeup of a successful tournament run. They've got the star power, a guy who can carry him, but they also have some role players. Brandon Knight, Zavatskas. But more importantly, they've got the chemistry of us versus them. They weren't supposed to be here, and I'm sure Ben Howland has reminded them of that.
And you can see that in Greer at the end of the game, what you just saw last night. There's a passion and excitement that you don't see from one of the teams that we know is going into the NCAA tournament through the Big East tournament. And that's the joy of watching this Pittsburgh team here tonight, playing with emotion and desperation. Let's check the AT&T starting lineup. With Greer, it's Isaac Hawkins and Donatas Zavatskas on the forward line. Zavatskas has played well. Brandon Knight and Julius Page in the backcourt. Knight a sophomore, Page an explosive jumping freshman. Ben Howland in his second year at Pittsburgh has turned this program around. 13 wins last year, 17 this season. For Syracuse, their AT&T starting lineup. Preston Shumpert has had two very good games. Damone Brown, Jeremy McNeil gets the start at center. Alan Griffin, the senior, 14 points, 6 points against John Linehan last night. And Deshaun Williams, who was the key man down the stretch for Syracuse. Jim Boeheim goes for win 600 in his 25-year career. His average record 24-8 over his 25 years. His team right now is 24-7. Keys to semifinal number two, Mr. Elmore.
Little musical keys right here. For Pittsburgh, just like the Steely Dan tune says, Ricky, don't lose that number. It's all about Greer. He sets the emotional tone, and the Panthers have to use emotion as a fuel to get past fatigue on the third night. And when you talk about Syracuse, we're going to talk about Keep On Trucking. That's Eddie Kendrick from The Temptations. They've got to establish the tempo, make sure they get easy shots, particularly get to the free throw line for some easy points.
Thank you, Casey Kasem. And now on with the countdown to see who will join Boston College. Pittsburgh, the lower seed, thus in the road jerseys for the third night. They've won back-to-back games in the Big East tournament for the first time in their 19 years in the conference.
Look how tight the top of that 2-3 is right now around the free throw line. Griffin and Williams. They don't want Knight having the ability to step inside the paint as he did the other night and create havoc.
Using the Hawkins pick, Zavatskas first shot. And Deshaun Williams takes the rebound for Syracuse. Alan Griffin's the point guard. Senior from Brooklyn. He's playing the best basketball the last 3 weeks of his career. Shumpert posting up on Knight.
Well, you'd think that other teams would learn. You can't put a point guard on Preston Shumpert because he's going to take you inside the paint and he's going to burn you.
A very long 6'6". Shumpert has been undefendable for teams thus far this week.
We had a chance to see when Greer receives down on the block the attention he's going to get.
Knight up top. It's tipped back in. Isaac Hawkins, who normally wears 52, is in jersey 44 because something happened to his road 52 jersey. So when they played at Syracuse, their regular season meeting about 10 days ago, Isaac had to wear 44, and he's still in it on the road.
Well, you know he's going to be in it as long as they're winning.
Shumpert missed. Weak side rebound. Center Jeremy McNeil, who traveled. Jim Higgins called it. Jim Burr, Bob Donato, the other officials.
Well, good recognition by Syracuse. They've had practice against Connecticut. They tried to use Talik Brown on Preston Shumpert, and he isolated and scored just pretty much the same way as he did there.
Shumpert had 31 against Connecticut, 14 in the win over Providence last night, our closest game of the tournament. foul on the outside is Deshaun Williams, his first.
And this is exactly what Syracuse does not want to happen. You take a look right here. Brandon Knight's going to receive, and he's going to make a move into the paint. We didn't have a chance to see him make that move, but he's going to get into the paint for sure if they continue to spread that and extend that 2-3 defense.
Knight's penetration was very important. 11 assist game in the win last night. McNeil blocks the shot of Page. Pittsburgh advancing by beating the top seed out of the West, Notre Dame, 66-54, and holding conference co-player of the year Troy Murphy in single digits for the second time in his career. Foul on Zavatkis.
Interesting strategy by Pittsburgh. Three possessions by Syracuse. Three different guys guarding Preston Shumpert. Ricky Greer is on him now.
Griffin watched by fellow number one, Julius Page. Senior against freshman here. Williams and Knight, a couple of sophomores. Here's Damone Brown.
Are they daring him to shoot?
He was very hot, 6 of 7 in the first half of the performance against Connecticut. Page trying to go up and dunk. McNeil got in the way defensively. Griffin off the feed from Williams.
Syracuse very successful last night attacking Providence despite Providence's penchant for pressure. They did a good job. They got to the free throw line. They got some easy baskets. And we mentioned before, it would be nice if you're a Syracuse fan, if your team can get to the free throw line, stop the clock, give people a rest, and still get some points.
Both teams are playing the third game in 3 days. Panthers use a little more bench than Syracuse. Zavatskis, line drive, triple for the Lithuanian sophomore. Shoots it at 46%. Didn't shoot enough to be a part of the league stats as one of the best three-point shooters.
You see Julius Page absolutely dogging Alan Griffin up and down the floor.
Brown missed it on the baseline. Hawkins came away with the Panther rebound. Pittsburgh team went 7-9 in the conference this year, finished fifth. That has made a run for the first time at the Garden.
Look at the extension. Once again, when we talk about the 2-3 zone, the back line of Syracuse, the extension of those long arms, it deters the passes along the baseline, at least from the wing.
Page was long and left.
And what's key about that is that's where Ricardo Greer likes to work, along the baseline. It'll be a very long night for Pittsburgh if they can't get him the ball.
Williams got a step on Knight. The offense from the outside for Deshaun Williams was non-existent the last few games of the regular season. About this point in the opening game of this tournament, he took a couple of poor shots. Boeheim sat him down. Since then, Williams has been driving and more productive offensively. Isaac, 6'8" senior, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Pittsburgh's first lead of the night at 7-6.
Now there's a switch. When Shumpert comes off the pick, the top guy, Knight, will switch on him, but that's why he's now caught with him. He's got to get some help.
Hawkins came to help. The contact with Williams and Greer at the top. Williams took a three. And when you say it so often, oftentimes players go inside to get their easy baskets and their outside game comes back.
Well, you better believe that players know what they're shooting in the course of a night. And if they're 0-for-5, 0-for-6, those jumpers are very difficult to put down. But if you got a 3-for-5 or a 4-for-6 or 4-for-7 going, you can relax when you take your jump shot.
Did you know your field goal accuracy in game? Zavatskis, second three.
Sure, and the teams that I played with, I could count to 10. That's about all I got.
Oh, here you go. Decades later, complaining about not enough shots. 10-9, Pittsburgh leads by 1, 6 minutes in. Mostly half-court stuff here in the first 6 minutes. Griffin finds McNeil. Zavatskis defensively. And he got the rebound. Zavatkis did a very nice job against Troy Murphy last night.
He certainly did. Again, held his own, kept his hands up, and waited for his help to come.
Interior pass to Hawkins, who was fouled.
Well, this is a surgical strike by Pittsburgh. They're looking to move the ball, get a situation where Greer or Hawkins will be in that short corner. And if they can run kind of a triangle, get the ball in there and force Syracuse to adjust, they've got a couple of options.
Well, Isaac Hawkins, a senior, he spent time in prep school, Hargrave Military Academy. That's a little bit older than some other seniors. He's going to turn 26 in September. We get one more free throw as a junior who's third team all Big East, and one of the reasons for his advanced age is an injury last year forced him to redshirt. Fractured his right fibia. The medical redshirt, now he's back with the Panthers. Had a good season too. 9.5 points, 8 boards. Moon over Manhattan. Pittsburgh, the early lead in this semifinal.
ESPN and ESPN2, home of the Women's NCAA Championship.
Money's in the air. Wireless companies keep investors talking. But it takes more than hot technology to get Janice excited. Janice bought into one company after learning their business from the inside out. Even projected how fast they could grow by counting their antennas and meeting their technicians on rooftops to see how fast they could install more. Now every signal says money to Janice. Get there. Janice Mutual Funds.
Make copies from your computer. Toshiba. Don't copy. Lead.
Reese Davis with you. Let's go out to the Big Ten. Penn State and Michigan State in a war. Tied at 49. Joe Crispin from very deep gave Penn State the lead. It's now a 2-point game. Alabama and Florida likewise locked up in a good one. 4-point game deep in the second half, Dave.
The AT&T Big East semifinals roll on from Madison Square Garden. Pittsburgh, good start on 14th rank. Syracuse, Dave Reinbach, courtside at MSG. It has been quite a six-day span indeed for Syracuse. Started here right this very floor on Sunday. A double overtime win over St. John's. The team then flew home that night to be home in time for their booster banquet. Well, they made it, but the banquet got canceled by weather the next day. So Tuesday morning, they took the train here. A six-hour ride. Now, guys, three games, three nights. Will they be tired? We'll find out.
Well, let's ask Mr. Elmore, when does fatigue become a factor, considering the double overtime game in addition to the travel changes and two games where the starters played most of the minutes?
Well, I like to look at consecutive games, particularly two in a row. It's the second game where you actually peak, I think. Players are sharper, they jump higher, they feel stronger. It's in the third game when you probably get around the 10-minute mark in the second half. We saw that a little bit with Seton Hall in the first game where they started to wilt with about 10, 8 minutes left in the second half. It also depends upon whether you're playing from behind or you're ahead. It's a lot easier to withstand fatigue when you're winning.
And off the inbound, Shumpert hands to Damone Brown, who curls it over the rim. We have both teams in the same situation playing a third game in 3 days. And as we mentioned earlier, neither team plays 9 or 10 guys.
Well, the thing about Pittsburgh, though, is the fact that they have an added incentive in that we talked about at the beginning of the telecast, the us versus them. They weren't supposed to be here. They're constantly reminded that they were an afterthought, but they're here and they like it here. Syracuse is one of those that was looked upon as a favorite, ranked in the top 25 just about all year. So their expectation is there. And finally for Pittsburgh, it's the only way they get to the NCAA.
Ricardo Greer, who has not taken a shot in the first 720, has only one assist. Still, his team leads by one as Torrey Morris gets Isaac Hawkins. Ben Howland sends his 6'10 freshman center from Tennessee onto the floor. Syracuse sweeping the regular season meetings between these teams. Lucky they get away with a win early in the season. Second conference game down in Pittsburgh. McNeil to Jared Knight. Still Panther ball. They played February 27th, last Tuesday of the regular season up at Syracuse, and that was a very easy Syracuse win, easier than the final score of 80-69 indicated. Most of the second half, Syracuse led by somewhere in the neighborhood of 18, 20 points. Alan Griffin in that game had a triple-double in his final Carrier Dome game. Griffin on the take around Jerron Brown. It was goaltending, so it scored anyway. Get back to Dave Ryan.
Well, guys, we talked about Alan Griffin and how busy he's been over the past six games, including now two and a half here at the Big East tournament. He's played in all 10 seconds of final send-off in his final home game. So it's 249 minutes, 50 seconds out of 258 total minutes. Guys, last night, turns out he had cramps in both legs. Repeatedly had to get up and get rehydrated because he's been that exhausted. We'll see how it affects him tonight.
He told us, Dave, after he never has problems with cramping, but was suffering from it last night. Chad Johnson in the game. Griffin with the strip. Didn't have numbers and finds the space.
So when you talk about Griffin's minutes, I'm sure if you asked him about the alternative, he wouldn't consider coming out.
He looks really sluggish right now, doesn't he? Damone Brown getting a couple of minutes on the bench as Griffin has scored three field goals, all layups. That's a busy man. He's in shape. Greer's first shot of the night is a miss. Jerron Brown gets the rebound. Brown and Johnson on the floor off the Pitt bench with Morris. Greer let Shumpert fly by and found the wide open Knight. Pitt's outside shooting has been poor thus far.
And they haven't been able to really penetrate the 2-3 zone. Knight goes in one time and gets stripped.
Chad Johnson defensively against Alan Griffin, a 6'5", former Nebraska player. Shumpert and Knight battling, and Shumpert got caught for the offensive foul. Knight was pushing. Shumpert got a little angular with the arms and picked up the personal. Team foul two on Syracuse. Just one on fifth. Was a very nice start. Easy, relaxed so far.
Cup of coffee, please, and a straw. Thanks. He walked right by me. Hey, what's this?
Truck experts love the Toyota Tundra. But when J.D. Power and Associates asked owners to rate their experience, Tundra was ranked best full-size pickup in initial quality and most appealing full-size pickup.
Look at you. You keep eating those donuts, you're going to be a full-size pickup.
The Toyota Tundra, better from the ground up.
Next stop, Chunkyville, population U.
Who's your friend, Mark?
He's a venture capitalist.
Oh, are you still trying to trademark the dot and dot com?
Okay, if I can get just a little investment from you, this is a go. I'll take that as a yes. Mom, I gotta send an email here. I need an upgrade.
You need a data port.
That's, yes.
What's this look like, sweetie? A Holiday Inn?
Data ports, meeting rooms, business services. Holiday Inn gives you more, and more is better.
Tempting, flirtatious, seductive. And that's just the Fender. It's that time of year at Pep Boys, where you can save over $90 on these great car care products. Fall in love with your car again at Pep Boys.
The stuffed crust pizza from Pizza Hut is just $9.99. And now, for just a buck more, add on 5 breadsticks, or a 2-liter bottle of Pepsi, or even 5 buffalo wings. So wing it up, stick it up, drink it up, or wing it up, stick it up, stick it up. Just buck it up. Only a buck each. But you better hurry it up before time is up.
3-point lead for Syracuse over Pittsburgh. Winner gets Boston College in tomorrow night's title game at 8 Eastern on ESPN. Syracuse trying to get to the championship game for the 12th time, more than anyone else. Pittsburgh has never played in the Big East championship game. Ricardo Greer is trying to change that and extend his Big East career. The senior, who has been the horse for the Panthers in the first couple of games, And in the first half win of both games, he's averaged 12.5 points, 5 rebounds, and taken 8 shots. Here, nothing except the one miss.
Well, he's allowing the game to come to him, recognizing again that against this 2-3 zone, his neighborhood has kind of been changed a little bit. Along the baseline, he's had difficulty. So what Ben Hallen seems to have done is make an adjustment, bring him out to the wing now, find a way to slip him into the paint or for an open jumper.
Damone Brown knocked it away from Jerron Brown. Jerron Brown got it back and got the two. Jerron Brown, a redshirt freshman from Lexington, Kentucky, who's been playing more and playing better. 6 assists in the first game here, 14 points, a career high last night. And Ben Hallen said, I'm obviously not very smart. I should have started playing him more a lot earlier. Last touch by Shumpert. But in Hallen's defense, and he was kind of tongue-in-cheek saying that, Jerron Brown's confidence built because Brandon Knight, the starting point guard, had a foot injury, slowed him the last few games, and he had to use Jerron Brown more. And all of a sudden, the light went on.
And particularly in a half court set, Jerron Brown, very good, bringing the ball up, getting the offense started, and then leaving it for others to get some stuff done.
Ricardo Greer tried to throw the lob to Julius Page. It didn't work. That's 2 tried lobs by the Panthers. Quest Dwaney, first touch in the offensive set. Billy Selick, 35, is in for Syracuse. They're posting up Shumpert. It's almost like an NBA situation. As soon as they see anybody smaller, and this time Brown, the fourth player to try and defend Shumpert tonight, they go to their big guy and Preston scores.
But what a lot of teams have done against Syracuse in a situation where you have a mismatch with one of their frontline guys, Brown and Shumpert, they've taken Selick's man and they've gone. This situation for Pittsburgh is literally the same, and I'm surprised that they haven't done that.
Page works the right side. Hawkins doubled. Shot clock reset off the missed shot, so plenty of time for the Panthers as we get to the 9-minute mark. Page turned away on the baseline. A nice job, though, to find Hawkins. Jerron Brown, 3. Confidence growing for Brown, just a 14% three-point shooter on this season.
Well, he was dead on target right there, right in front of an extended free throw. Those are the easy ones to make.
Jerron Brown, 2 of 15 on the season from 3. Billy Selick with the drive.
Talk about confidence.
Now, what'd you say this morning? You thought that Selick's minutes last night were very important.
Oh, they were. And again, they don't show up on the stat sheet. Selick has a knack for setting picks, for getting guys free, being annoying to the defender, and it really helps his teammates get to the spots they need to in order to score.
Pittsburgh timeout. At the 8:18 mark, Syracuse by 2.
Southwest Airlines asks, does your friend deserve to fly free? Have they ever helped you paint your house? Have they ever told you you had a large piece of food between your teeth? Have they ever helped you move? Have they always accepted you for who you are? Then chances are your friend is more than worthy of the Friends Fly Free deal from Southwest Airlines. Travel by May 23rd from Islip MacArthur to Providence for $49 and a friend comes along absolutely free. Of course, make sure you have another friend to take care of things while you're away.
You are now free to move about the country.
Right now, when you buy a new Polaris ATV, you get a 2,000-pound Warn winch kit for just $69. Or choose low 3.9% financing.
This Sunday on ESPN Classic.
60 seconds on the mat and you're dog meat.
Find out what it takes.
You're on a vision quest, man.
To be a champion. One man must decide just how far he's willing to go.
You've done everything you came here to do?
Yeah.
To be the best. Matthew Modine stars in a real classic. Vision Quest. This Sunday night at 9 Eastern, 10 Pacific. Only on ESPN Classic. To get real, call 1-800-CLASSIC today.
Let's finish up a couple of stories we've been following for you. Pittsburgh and Syracuse, obviously a two-point game. Alabama and Florida, that's finished now. The Gators held off the Tide 69-61, the score in that one. And Penn State and Michigan State, a two-point game. If that is this tight at the end, we'll try to take you out there for the finish.
All right, Reese, we'll give it up as soon as you guys are ready. Here, Syracuse leads Pittsburgh by two. The Panthers leader, Ricardo Greer, is part of Big East history, along with his brother, Jeff Greer. They passed the Curley brothers of BC fame as the best scoring brothers in the history of the league. Jeff on Rutgers on the left side of the screen, and Ricardo on the right. And they're standing by, the non-playing one right now, with Dave Ryan.
Yeah, two of the teams of the Big East did not make it to this Big East championship. Unfortunately, you, Jeff Greer, but you're still able to root on your brother Ricardo. Is it difficult not being able to play from the sidelines here?
Yeah, it's definitely difficult, but I'm just glad that he's having a great tournament. He's playing well, and his team's playing well.
You know these teams very well. How about the second half and the remaining 8 minutes here in the first half? Who's going to come out on top, in your opinion?
I think Pitt is playing inspired basketball right now, and if they can just stay close and make it a tight game towards the end, they have a great chance of winning because they're such a close team, and anything can happen in this tournament.
How much does it mean for Ricardo to be here in New York and have success the last couple of nights? He told me yesterday he couldn't even describe it, put it into words.
Yeah, it's great for him because he hasn't had great games at the Garden. I mean, the last couple of years he's gone to the biggest tournament and had it was one and done. They came in here and they were gone. So, I mean, they're having some success this year, and I'm just happy for him.
From Washington Heights, what was the name of the park you guys learned your craft?
Oh, there was a whole bunch of 189 Park, Fort Tryon Park. I mean, everywhere. Anywhere there was a hoop, we were there.
All right, Jeff, thanks so much. Mike, between the two Greer brothers, someone trying to make the NCAAs for the first time.
Steal off the inbounds. Knight challenges Brown. He scored it with a foul. Speaking of brothers, the younger brother of NBA star Brevin Knight, Brandon Knight, gets the hoop and the foul.
Clear case of brain lock on the part of Damone Brown, expecting his teammate to cut one way, but not careful with the ball. Right there, just gives it to Jerron Brown. Jerron Brown, in turn, sets up his teammate.
Completes the three-point play, and the Panthers lead by that margin as we get to the eight-minute mark in the first half. A little pressure extended by Pitt. Well, that steal was created because of surprise pressure. It wasn't expected. I think Jerron Brown may have even been acting upon his own. That's what happens. You get to play more, you get the freedom.
Dwayne drove the baseline, and that foul's offensive. The arm was extended to give him space.
So with Ricky Greer on the bench and Jeff Greer watching on the sideline, Pittsburgh has taken a lead by three. Jeff's waiting for his little brother to get back in the game. His bigger brother, excuse me. I'm sure he will pretty soon. When he does, his team will be on top.
How to speak Australian.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. Your table's all ready? Thanks.
Great.
Oi!
Keeper.
Shall we?
Absolutely.
Beer. Foster's. Australian for beer.
You want me?
Back off! He's the killer!
Put the food down. Walk away. Nobody gets hurt.
Let's do it! Yeah! I got him!
Think you're tough enough to drive a Tacoma?
Give me back!
Join the club. Introducing the double cab with over 5 feet of bed length.
You just can't mess with a man's salad.
Word up.
Well, you take a look right now at how Pittsburgh is trying to guard Preston Shumpert. Again, utilizing some switching tactics, utilizing different defenders. There was Brandon Knight, there's Jeff Greer, now Julius Page. Now Zavatka switches off the pick. And once again, when he gets in the paint, you got to put a body on him. Jerron Brown fighting to get in front. And you also have to put pressure on the ball. Those are the missing parts of that equation. But it, so far, it's been relatively effective. In the first two games, Preston Shumpert off to quick starts. Today, he's human.
Two of three from the field. So just three field goal attempts. Not a lot of opportunities to take shots.
So Shumpert, the Syracuse first-team All-League performer, and Greer, the second-team All-League performer for Pitt, quiet offensively. Panthers lead by three. Selick goes to the ground with that broken hand and comes away with the turnover.
And as we mentioned about Billy Selick, there's no box on the stat sheet that you can check for that kind of play.
Shumpert three.
But he's as responsible for that three as Preston Shumpert.
Ball square 22. Syracuse has made its last five shots. Greer set to check in for next dead ball.
Well, he's had a chance to gain some perspective right now to take a look at the defense and kind of mentally place himself on the floor to find out where the opportunities are.
Duck by Zavatskis. Damone Brown blocked Chad Johnson. Four to shoot. Jerron Brown saw the clock and Brown got it out of there. Shot clock violation.
That little rest for Damone Brown a few moments ago seems to have revitalized him.
Shumpert's going to get a break on the bench as well here. 22-22 at the 6:40 mark. Talk about three games in 3 days for both teams. A little more substitution. Shumpert thought he was coming out. Dwayne instead came out. He was fouled by Jerron Brown. It's kind of been slow starting both games in the first half. Any reason you think the three games in 3 days feeling out process is a factor?
Yeah, I think it is. I think mentally both teams are aware of what they have accomplished and where they are right now. And maybe they're trying to pace themselves a little bit. That's maybe unfortunate in some respects, particularly for a team like Pittsburgh that needs to get out front for a longer period of time, needs to create some distance. Because they're a team, quite honestly, not as talented as Syracuse. But if Syracuse doesn't get out front either and they allow Pittsburgh to stay in the game long enough, the Panthers start to believe they can win this one also.
Syracuse extends the lead. They've had it a few times. Shumpert has nine. Greer back in the game. Kicked it out to Jerron Brown. Selick the rebound. John Williams with the cut. Ran into Isaac Hawkins. Too tall for him. Chad Johnson on the fly.
Great recognition by Brandon Knight. Saw him all the way. Just waited until the traffic cleared before he launched that one.
If you expect to be any good in Eastern basketball, you better have a good point guard. But the unheralded point guards in this league have had very good seasons. And Brandon Knight to that lately. Griffin protected and connected.
I like when Alan Griffin drives into a crowd. He kind of tucks that ball away as though he's diving for a first down, but still has the dexterity to bring it back up and lay it in.
Walt Frazier left a few of his ad-libs here at the table before the Knicks left town for the tournament.
Did I say something like that?
No, I did. Yeah, okay. It stumbled on it. Clear. On another feed from Knight. There's Jeff seeing his brother get on the score page for the first time. All even at 26. Griffin beating Brown. Kind of in between, went to pass it, nobody to pass it to. Brandon Knight, head on a swivel, looking for help. Greer, the baseline shut off by Selick's defensive help.
He got himself in trouble that time. You still got to recognize what's open against that back line.
Damone Brown tried to keep it alive, and he was out of bounds. Shumpert was looking over at Griffin from the time they got to midcourt on the run. It was right on our angle of eyesight. Press kind of eyebrows raised. Hey, hey, hey.
So when you're a shooter, though, it doesn't matter where the ball is.
Well, we have a second. Let's send it back to the studio. Update for the game in Chicago, Reese.
All right, Mike. Joe Crisp and Jason Richardson have both just hit incredible three-pointers. 1 point Penn State lead, 7.4 seconds to go in the Big Ten. Let's go out to Chicago now.
7.4 remaining in this one. Penn State basketball, they lead by the slimmest of margins. The inbound to Joe Crisp and a foul here, and he'll go to the line. Best free throw shooter in the Big Ten heading to the free throw stripe. Moments ago, he delivered a three-point dagger. These free throws would be nails in the Michigan State coffin. It's a one-point ball game. He'll get two at the line, and then it would take a miracle triple by Michigan State just to get this thing to overtime. How about this? First round, defeated Michigan. Quarterfinals, defeated the top seed last year, Ohio State. The semifinals eventually lost to Illinois. Jerry Dunn's been here before, and yes, he has pulled off upsets in the Big Ten tournament. What a job he's done, and boy, if there's any doubt that Penn State deserves to go to the NCAA, tonight's game should expunge those doubts from anyone, especially if they hang on a win. And again, if Crispin makes both of the line, I'm sure that's what Tom Izzo's counting on. Crispin makes them both, then Michigan State's got to get a quick three to get this thing to an extra session.
And we've talked about the statistical indexes that can point to a potential Penn State win. What's something that's not going to show up win is the great job that Penn State did in getting back in defensive transition, really taking away for large stretches of the game Michigan State's early offense, particularly being able to go down low.
Crispin is 5 of 5 at the free throw line. Remember the ingredients into postseason upsets. Teams that hit three-point field goals, teams that shoot well from the free throw line. That's Penn State. The ingredients are there. And this may be one of the biggest upsets in the country. Two at the line for Joe Crispin, as expected. Timeout taken by Penn State to set the defense. 5.7 remaining. Michigan State 24-3. Their only losses on the road at Indiana, Ohio State, and Illinois.
Okay, so it's a three-point game right now. You're going to draw something up for them, Digger, for Michigan State?
I'll tell you, that was a smart timeout right now. You have to do that. Even though you've got the lead, you've got to set your defense. So you make the free throws, a great timeout by Jerry Dunn, so that you've got everybody in place in case somebody comes down out of control. A lot of teams will just take it down and go and score, and no one knows who to pick up, and that's where you get beat or get tied for that three. But this was a key timeout for Jerry Dunn's defense. Penn State really playing well to pull this thing off.
Yeah, they still got 5.7 to go. They've certainly got the edge in this one. Crispin's been brilliant in the second half. Let's go back out to Chicago. Wayne Larrivee and Sean Morris
Mike
for the finish.
Chappelle will inbound. Mike Chappelle inbounds for Michigan State. 5.7 remaining. Michigan State needs three to tie. Richardson, Charlie Bell on the floor. Andre Hudson, the inbounds to Hudson. Quickly advancing. Time winding down, and a foul by Crispin. John Crispin makes the foul, and with 1.5 seconds remaining, before Taylor turned to shoot.
A very smart play.
Yep.
And a play that cost them, the play they didn't make earlier in the season, Wayne. They allowed Kirk Haston to shoot a three to send it into overtime. Here, they give the foul, going to force Taylor to make the first, try to miss the second, and hope for a tip.
Taylor is 0 for 2 at the free throw line. He has not scored in the game here tonight.
Hey, let's go.
1.5 remaining. It's a two-shot foul. Both teams in the double bonus. He makes his first. Now, you would expect he'd miss the second, right?
That's why Zach Randolph's coming in. He's been very, very active on the offensive glass. Now, if you're Penn State, I'd have that guy pinched down. Ivory's going to have to pinch down and give help to Klein Herd. It doesn't look like that's what they're going to do.
Two good offensive rebounds. Rebounders on the floor. The rebound, Igakazi. As time expires, this game is over. Jerry Dunn and the seventh seed.
Okay, Digger said it was a smart foul. It worked out. Penn State beats Michigan State 65-63. That's going to look good on the resume. Syracuse up by 2 on Pittsburgh, 28-26. 3:34 to go in the first half. We'll get you back to the Garden after the break.
I'm Dr. Norman Gary, and I'm a bee expert. All right, bee.
Dr. Norman Gary will do some pretty outrageous things.
I've been stung probably around 75,000 times.
But would Norm Gary ever get car insurance that didn't come with a State Farm agent?
Car insurance with no State Farm agent? Now that makes me nervous.
For car insurance, be like this State Farm customer.
Enjoy.
And get an agent you can rely on.
Here, have some more.
Plus competitive rates.
Beer is like a natural food product. The fresher it is, the better it tastes. That's why Budweiser has 12 local breweries right here in the United States. So you know our beer will always be fresh.
This one's for you.
Okay, you just saw the end of the Penn State-Michigan State game, the Nittany Lions winning that one. Now it's time to get you back out to the Big East, Pittsburgh and Syracuse. Mike Tirico.
All right, Reese, while we've been gone, Pitt scored 3, Syracuse 2. The Panthers lead by 1, 29-28. But Preston Shumpert was injured. We'll get to the story in a second. Ricky Greer hits the field goal. He now has 7 as he's starting to catch fire. And Pitt leads Syracuse 31-28. Shumpert took a shot in the head, finger in the eye or a bang to the head. Looked to be a little woozy on the bench as well. And was taken back to the locker room a couple of minutes ago. No medical report yet. We'll wait for that. Dave Ryan's checking on it also. In the interim, without Shumpert on the floor, Deshaun Williams missed. And Pittsburgh gets a little stretch going here. And Isaac Hawkins, who hit Shumpert a couple of minutes ago, took a shot in the face as well. Let's go back and show you how Shumpert was injured.
Well, it's really on a rebound. Missed opportunity by Hawkins right there, slapped out of his hands, and right there in the left of your screen, you'll see it right there. Right in his face, you see Hawkins' hand comes down, probably got his finger in the eye, and you can see the sting.
Dave Ryan, go ahead.
Just talk with team physician Irvin Raphael, guys. He will be back in the game in the next few minutes. They're clearing his vision with drops into the right eye, trying to get him back on the court as soon as possible. He will return tonight, they say.
Okay, Dave, thanks. Night of 3, misfired. Dwayne gets the rebound.
Well, they certainly need Preston Shumpert. No real outside threat with him there. They're forced to take their guards, try to drive to the basket as Damone Brown now becomes the center of attention, and he's not as versatile as Preston Shumpert.
Deshaun Williams is the better outside shooter of the men on the floor. He missed there. Knight on the push. Greer left free for a second. Got in the space of the zone, and a beautiful dish to Hawkins. Timeout Syracuse as Pittsburgh is taking its biggest lead of the night. And Isaac Hawkins has 10.
Ricky Greer just totally under control. Thought he had a jumper, head fake, gets him into the paint, and he just draws Dwayne. Another look right here. The no look from Knight. There's the head fake to get Griffin off his feet. Skips into the paint, and here's where you put pressure on that back line of Syracuse. They have to make a decision, and it's the wrong one.
While we were gone, in addition to Greer hitting a couple of free throws and Damone Brown hitting a couple of free throws, Pittsburgh had to take an extra 30-second timeout as they were trying to save a possession. So your timeout situation as Syracuse with 4, Pitt with 3. Well, we saw the dramatic win for Penn State that will certainly send them forward. They will take on the winner of the Iowa-Ohio State battle that was scheduled to come on the air in a couple of minutes on ESPN2. I'm sure they'll be showing you scores and highlights to get you ready, and then that game will start in about 17 minutes. EAS Mountain West semifinal at the Sports Center here on ESPN. New Mexico and Utah play at the Thomas and Mack Center just off the strip in Las Vegas.
So do you think Illinois is relieved, or are they going to feel some more stress now that they're the ones currently in the crosshairs of everyone else as the now favorite for the Big Ten tournament?
Possession arrow to Syracuse. I think if I was a Fighting Illini player, I'd be energized knowing that if you take care of business, you've got a chance for that number one seed. If there were questions about who would be the one seed of the Big Ten teams, Reese and Digger will have all the action coming up in the 7-Up halftime report. UMass with a huge win over St. Joseph's as well in the Atlantic 10. And all those games help the at-large calls for other causes for other teams. Thus, teams like Villanova and Connecticut in the Big East who are on the bubble have more things to worry about.
Well, again, if I'm Illinois, particularly, I'm not going to relax. I agree with you 100%. This is more important now that we take care of business, because it could be them next.
Right. That's exactly right. Questions here. Zavatskis and Billy Seelig were getting tangled up. And now we're resetting the shot clock to 35. The officials were discussing that as well. Report further from Dave Ryan in the back. Another one of the physicians is going to go back and check on Preston Shumpert. He will not be back here in this final 50 seconds of the first half. Pittsburgh better playing with the lead. Now a team suited for big comebacks is worked out an advantage here in this stretch, and Shumpert's been gone. That could be great fuel in their second half run. Page hurt his ankle. Dwayne missed everything. Shot clock is off.
I think Page got stepped on, but tremendous defense by him. Griffin wanted to get to the paint, wanted to get to the hole. They kept him from turning the corner.
So they'll essentially play four on four. Page is all the way out of the play. Now he touches. He can't go anywhere. Let's see.
Looks a lot better when he handles the ball. It's like an analgesic. You get your hand on the ball, the pain goes away.
Pittsburgh is going to go in with a lead. Will it be five or seven? Greer inside. No good. Halftime.
It's good if it goes.
Pittsburgh scores the last seven. Takes the advantage after the Shumpert injury. And Reese Davis, Pittsburgh's 20 minutes away from the opportunity everybody plays these tournaments for. One game to get to the tournament.
You're right, Mike. This is the craziest night of the year with all of the conference tournament action going on, and we've seen some upsets. You really like the way that Pittsburgh and Ben Howland, the way they're attacking Syracuse right now.
Well, I had a little preview last night going against Notre Dame's 2-3 zone, and what Greer and Knight do is penetration bottoms the zone. That's why they're able to break it up, get the easy points. Knight last night had 11 assists against the Irish, and you can see why tonight they're doing the same strategy.
Coming up on the 7-Up Halftime Report, we'll break down the conference tournament action, what it means to all of those teams sweating out hopeful at-large bids. That's coming up.
ESPN's presentation of the AT&T Big East Tournament, presented by AT&T, is brought to you by Toyota. More choices, better selection. Experience Toyota today. And by Royal Caribbean. The world is waiting for you. Get out there. ESPN's presentation of the AT&T Big East Tournament, presented by AT&T, is brought to you by Paxil and by Mazda.
Pittsburgh 33, Syracuse 28 as we start the second half of the second semifinal in the AT&T Big East Championship. The winner gets Boston College in the title game. Syracuse without Preston Shumpert and without him for the rest of the game. We'll get to Dave Ryan in a second for the details, but Shumpert did not come out with the team in the layup line. He came out on the court briefly, and let's go to Dave right now.
All right, Mike, it's a corneal abrasion in the right eye for Preston Shumpert, the Syracuse leading scorer, when he got poked in the first half by Isaac Hawkins. As you mentioned, he is done for the game. He's got a patch over the right eye. He should be back out to watch the second half pretty soon. They gave him some antiseptic drops in the right eye to improve the vision, but it's still very blurry. He can't see well enough to play, Mike.
Okay, Dave, thanks. So Syracuse will be without Shumpert for the balance of the game. Griffin trying to get the team going, and Len, tell us the impact without the first-team all-conference performer.
Well, Syracuse is a fragile team offensively to begin with. Shumpert at 20 points a game is more than a quarter of the Syracuse output. What's going to have to happen right now, guys like Alan Griffin, Damone Brown, and Deshaun Williams are going to have to step up on the offensive end. But you know what? Defensively is also where Syracuse can cover for the loss of Preston Shumpert, creating some opportunities in transition.
Quest Dwayne, who steps in the lineup for Shumpert, is short on his shot. Got his rebound back, though. Griffin faked the three and got close for two.
And Mike, you notice I didn't mention the guys off the bench like Dwayne or McNeil having to step up, because you don't expect more from them than they're capable of giving you on a consistent basis. Griffin has had big games. Damone Brown has had big games. Deshaun Williams has had a big game. So they know that it's within one of those guys or all of them collectively.
Three-point game as the Panthers work around the zone. They were led by Isaac Hawkins, who had 10. Ricky Greer quiet early, then had 7. McNeil gets the rebound.
I tell you, one other key element will be Pittsburgh. They also are aware that Preston Shumpert is not coming back. The fact is, they cannot relax. They cannot take it easy. We saw a turnover from Zavakis. We saw a misfire by Ricky Greer. They're going to have to be even more focused on trying to do the things they necessarily have to win this game.
And this is Pitt's opportunity. You work all year for opportunity. You're never going to know when it comes, and here it is. You're ahead 5. The team you're playing against is without by far its best offensive weapon, as Len said. 2/7 of their offense comes from Preston Shumpert. And if you can have an advantage over Syracuse for the next 20 minutes, you'll play tomorrow night for an NCAA berth, something no Panther dreamed of when they came here this week. Instead, Syracuse has scored the first 4 of the half.
And the defense seems a little bit more porous than it was in the first half. The other side of it for Syracuse, once again, is the fact that this is the type of adversity that might galvanize the team, bring them closer together, force guys to execute better.
Off the missed transition, Damone Brown handles, gets it to Griffin, the point guard.
You know, when you don't have Shumpert to rely on, you feel you have to do the little things to make up for him.
Williams turned it over. Page is fouled by Griffin. Well, Len, when you talk about all these situations, this is something Jim Boeheim touched on last night when I saw him after Syracuse's second round win. He said, for some reason, this group of guys is really tough. They're 10-1 in games decided by 10 points or less, and this will be one more test of the moxie of this group.
Well, it certainly will be, and as we say, guys have to bring it individually but also collectively. As we mentioned, Griffin, Brown, Williams, they're going to have to find what they have inside of them. Sometimes you subordinate for the team. Well, if you have that individuality, you've got to bring it. And this is probably what Jim Boeheim is talking about. Don't do too much, but we need more.
And Boeheim went down the bench for a sub, but the guys out of that rotation of 7 weren't there, so he had to turn to James Theus, who hasn't played in the first 2 games. The freshman from Martin Luther King High School in Detroit is in the game. Played in 21 games of the season. But 4 points in Big East play.
Well, you see, Deuce has brought the ball up, but Ron Brown really pressuring Alan Griffin, trying not to let him get it. They want the freshman to have to withstand all of the focus.
We know one thing, 15 and White is fresh. Griffin protects and connects again. Patented move. He watched Pearl Washington videotape. Would go into assistant coach Mike Hopkins and try to watch tapes of Pearl so he could master a crossover. But to think people in the future will come back and watch Griffin, that little protect move as he comes through the lane.
And what Syracuse has done on the offensive end is that they've made it more comfortable for Griffin to work. They go to a 1-4, which allows him to get off at the top in a one-on-one situation.
Jerron Brown misfired. Chad Johnson crashed the glass but lost it. Here's this, the lob for Dwayne, who missed but Brown finished. And Pittsburgh takes time. And a lot of the guys off the bench come to the guy who they've spent a lot of time with on the bench. The alley-oop wasn't completed, but set up the weak side hoop.
Well, here's the crossover by Alan Griffin right here between his legs. There it is. Behind the back. And you see, not a lot of help until he gets close to the basket. It's because Syracuse has spread the floor. And again, you see the alley-oop, but the follow by Damone Brown. And here's a guy that hasn't played much. You look at those high white socks. Not a stain on.
This last attempted a field goal at West Virginia, February 17th. Give you an idea of how little he's done lately. He had an assist in that game. Alan Griffin. Len had the musical theme earlier. I Am Iron Man would apply to Alan Griffin. Played every minute of this AT&T Big East Championship thus far. Where Pittsburgh goes once again, this is their opportunity. Rear baseline turned away. Baseline jumper goes for Ricky. And Ricky Greer again more comfortable on that baseline. The ball movement tends to move that back line up and allows him the freedom of movement along that baseline. Kind of Griffin sliding over to the two. Theisen. Waiting. It's offensive. Perfect example of not expecting guys to do more than they're capable of doing. And that's what Quest Dwayne has done, and it's gotten him in trouble.
He's picked up three. First player with three personal fouls. Official timeout under 16 minutes. All even at 36.
Every Thursday, it's Thursday Night College Basketball from 9 to 11 on ESPN Classic.
If a car company puts a little sports car in everything it builds, imagine what happens when it builds a sports car.
Zoom, zoom. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Yeah, zoom, 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 zoom.
Introducing the new Mazda Miata. Six speeds, VVT engine. Even more fun.
Yeah, 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 zoom.
The company that reinvented the Roadster keeps reinventing the Roadster.
Four identical cars. Four identical engines. Only one running on new Havoline, our latest triumph in Havoline motor oil technology. And what difference does that make? Not only do you get unsurpassed performance, but tests show that with new Havoline under the hood, you get better gas mileage. Havoline, add more life to your car.
That bolt was torqued on in Detroit. There's no shame in using the hot wrench to get it apart. But what if you're out of acetylene? There's still a last resort they call the cold wrench. Promise yourself a taste of the high life and see if you don't find new strength to get to Miller time.
Friday night in Times Square, the studio where they do Good Morning America, the big screen. That recent Digger. Digger's been telling me for years how big he is in Manhattan. And there he is, larger than life.
Well, he's always wanted a long run on Broadway. You got it.
Who will have a long run in the field of 65? Join us in 90 minutes, the men's tournament selection special at 6:30 Eastern. Chris Fowler hosts with Dick and Digger, Jay Billis as well. Preston Shumpert with the corneal abrasion. 4 minutes left first half. Has come back out to the bench to watch his teammates, who fell behind by five at the half without Shumpert, but have come back to tie the game here 5 minutes in. Second half, the winner gets Boston College, an easy winner over Seton Hall. Isaac Hawkins now has a dozen, 10 in the first half for a player who had his career best game against Syracuse. He scored 32 against the Orangemen back in 98.
That timeout had to do wonders for Pittsburgh, particularly without Shumpert on the floor. You know that they prepared for him for this particular game. And now that he's not in and they know he's not coming back, they may have to take another plan of attack.
Griffin bounced to Dwayne. Deshaun Williams came back in, as you saw with a defensive trick. McNeil with the follow. And the Syracuse centers gave them no points in the first game, 9 points in last night's victory, and four thus far here. Hawkins runs the free throw line.
That shot's there all night.
What you think about putting somebody else there to take it?
Well, Hawkins has shown that he can hit the ball, the shot, and the question is, who do you put there? Who's going to have the presence of mind and the calm demeanor at that top to be able to hit those?
Well, Dwayne's just picked up his fourth foul, and that's a point that gets amplified because of Shumpert's injury. If you were not with us late first half, here was Shumpert battling with Isaac Hawkins. and got an accidental finger in the eye, and you can see it was bothering him on the bench. A corneal abrasion. So he went to the locker room, had it checked out. At first they thought he was going to be back, but then further examination found the injury. So Dwayne has four and stays on the floor. Brandon Knight at three. Damone Brown will let it go out of bounds.
Well, Pittsburgh can't just settle for the long jump shots. That's what the zone is inviting. They've got to continue to be able to move the ball, get it back inside. Hawkins doesn't have to shoot that, but when he's in there, the zone contracts. He can find people. That's excellent help by Zavatskis, and that's the adjustment Pittsburgh has made, recognizing that Griffin now will take on more of the offensive load, particularly off the dribble. They're hedging, stepping out beyond those picks, forcing him wide and forcing him to do things that he doesn't like.
Watch all the scores go by on what is always the busiest day of championship week with all the power leagues going, many of them in quarterfinals, the Big East, and A-10 in semifinals. On the move is Griffin. Dwayne has four fouls, so he can't be aggressive and drive. Nice pass to Sean Williams to Damone Brown, and the free throw is caught.
You hit the nail right on the head. Dwayne did a nice job of pulling up. Normally, he probably would have taken that ball to the basket aggressively. Look at him slam on the brakes right there to avoid running in the night. And then a nice find by Williams underneath as Pittsburgh did not recover once they stopped the ball.
I wasn't laughing at what happened or what you said, but as the scores went by, LSU has beaten Arkansas. The LSU team that only had a couple of conference wins and beat Georgia last night. A chance to advance again. Holy Cross, coached by former Pittsburgh coach Ralph Willard, in the field of 64 with an overtime win earlier on ESPN. Them both. And Brown's an 80% shooter. All even at 38. Richie Greer. He's the star for the Panthers. Field goal thus far in the second half.
You know, it's amazing. Obviously, we talk about the Shumpert story and him not being in the game, but Syracuse is playing the same defense. Pittsburgh just seems tentative for some reason.
Yes, they do. Zavatskis. His line drive jumper is good.
You gotta let it flow, right, Ben? Make it flow.
Let's go, Orange!
You know, for the amount of Syracuse fans that are in here, it's a half of a decent number, anyway. Yeah. Maybe they're tired of third game in 3 nights.
They're
quiet. We talked about Pittsburgh not having a large traveling party with them after the Syracuse turnover, their eighth of the game. Pittsburgh has never won back-to-back games in the Big East tournament, so it's not like the fans plan on it during the season. But all of a sudden, with a couple of wins here and an opportunity to build some positive momentum and change past struggles for Pitt.
Well, if the Pittsburgh faithful who came here didn't bring enough clothes, nowhere better to be than the fashion capital of the world to go out and spend a little money.
12 to shoot. Greer at the opening of the zone. Zavatskis. Let two go by. Foul on Greer.
Oh, you said Zavatskis, excuse me. Talk about the role players stepping up. Jeremy McNeil is one of those guys blocking shots, getting rebounds.
Three on Zavatskis. Pittsburgh leads by two. They're trying to make some hoops to the ESPN zone.
AT&T's broadband technology is revolutionizing telecommuting. It's up to 50 times faster than your standard modem, so you can download a 100-page multimedia presentation while you upload your socks.
What would happen if an SUV were raised by a family of sports cars?
Samsung.
Zoom, zoom, zoom. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Yeah, zoom, 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 zoom. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Introducing the 200 horsepower Mazda Tribute. The SUV with the soul of a sports car.
Birds do it. Bees do it. Guys with SUVs do it. It's that time of year at Pep Boys. Get free installation of Gabriel Pro Rider Premium Shocks. Fall in love with your car again at Pep Boys.
The stuffed crust pizza from Pizza Hut is just $9.99. And now, for just a buck more, add on 5 breadsticks, or a 2-liter bottle of Pepsi, or even 5 buffalo wings. So wing it up, stick it up, drink it up, or wing it up, stick it up, stick it up. Just buck it up. Only a buck each. But you better hurry it up before time is up.
Big E's!
Guys have watched some interesting basketball. I thought we'd see more competitive basketball than we've seen, but the stories have become teams like Pittsburgh, led by Ben Howland, their second-year coach who came from Northern Arizona, Brandon Knight, a point guard who's emerged here this week, and put the Panthers in position to erase bad memories, bad past tournament performances, and get the opportunity to get the Big East automatic bid. Double dribble called on Damone Brand. Syracuse has turned it over for their last 5 possessions.
Well, it's about different philosophies, instilling a desire and a confidence in winning that Ben Howland's job has been at Pittsburgh. Jim Boeheim doesn't have to worry about that with his success. But it takes a while. I think this is probably a quicker progression than Howland could have ever dreamed.
Chad Johnson, one of the players new to this program, transferred from Nebraska. And he draws the foul on Williams. Well, Ben Howland took over a program that had troubles with academics, players who weren't the kind that you wanted in a program if you're trying to build something long-term success. And he brought a three-point shooting style from his past coaching days at Northern Arizona, adapted the style to the players he had with a short bench last year when 13-15. And performances from freshman Julius Page this year, who scored 9 points a game, helped turn things around to a winning season for Pitt, which has only been to 2 NCAA tournaments in the decade of the 90s and won just 1 tournament game.
Don't forget, he brought the weed killer and got with the guys who were really having an adverse impact on his program. But some of those guys actually had, one in particular, had some skill. So that's a tough decision.
Williams on the drive. And Deshaun was fouled. You see, Pittsburgh is approaching a win total. They haven't seen the likes of that since 96-97. And Ben was very blunt in accepting the past failures of Pittsburgh in this event. He said, we'd like to go up to New York and spend some time there. After all, as one of the charter members of the Big East, essentially, not part of the expansion when the league went to 13 teams back 5 years ago. And Pittsburgh had the least success of the group that had been there the longest time. Alan Griffin for a Syracuse team that has been to 11 Big East championship games, trying to get to a 12th. Jim Boeheim with a win tonight not only gets to his 12th title game, but gets career win number 600. And you look at the 7 names ahead of him, and they are some of the elite in the history of the profession. It's the active coaches who have 600 wins. Boeheim trying to get there. With his win at the ACC tournament tonight, Mike Krzyzewski joins Jim Calhoun with 598. .17 to shoot. Williams dribbled it off the foot of Chad Johnson. Here under 10 minutes. Your old coach, Lefty Drizel, Jim Phelan, Mount St. Mary's. Tark still at it. Eddie Sutton, likely back to the tournament. Oklahoma State, a couple of point loss to Texas. And Cheney and Temple in a battle, trailing GW by a few. Griffin was way off, knew it, got there first.
And that's a good sign for Syracuse. They seem to want it more than Pittsburgh right now. But beating them to the loose ball.
Maybe some of the tired legs showing up on a couple of shots that came up short from Griffin and Dwayne.
Well, I can understand Griffin. Dwayne hasn't had that much time out there on the floor. Remember, we saw when Griffin played just about every minute of this tournament. 39.8 minutes is what he averaged.
Hawkins blocked by McNeil. And a foul is called on the Pittsburgh center.
And we talked about that shot being there all night unless McNeil decides to come out. Hawkins has to be patient enough to locate the defender. Locate McNeil. Have McNeil give himself up one way or the other. If he doesn't come out, shoot the jumper. If he comes out, there's somebody to slide the ball to down low.
9-10 left. Pittsburgh leading by two. Syracuse swept the regular season meetings between these teams. Jeremy McNeil called for the called for 3 seconds as he was camping out in the lane. Zavatskis back in for Johnson. And Syracuse very good taking care of the ball, just 13 turnovers per game, now has 12 in the first 31 minutes. This game is ripe for the taking. Will somebody please step up? It's almost like these two teams playing the third game in 3 days are holding some energy for the run. Zavatskis at three. Ricardo Grill locating Zavatskis on the weak side. And that's what I meant by patience. If Hawkins can exhibit that type of patience in the middle, Pittsburgh will get an awful lot of open shots. Brown working on Hawkins. Use the window. 43-40. Brown has eight. They react to Zavatskis. Double Hawkins. Jerron Brown cut inside, and Griffin's quick hands took it away. Dwayne finds Williams. Zavatskis waits for the goal. He has done a lot of little things, and Donatas Zavatskis and Brandon Knight together. Of course, Greer gets the headlines that those guys are really making an impression on the conference here this week.
Well, they certainly are, and it goes back to what we talked about before. Pittsburgh has the classical makeup of a successful tournament run. They've got star power, somebody that the defenses have to focus on, but it's the role players and also the chemistry, us versus them, that kind of fuels this run.
Good feed to Hawkins. Pittsburgh by five. Seven assists now for Brandon Knight, who had 11 last night. Back out. Good defense by Jerron Brown. Damone Brown baseline jumper. Dwayne the putback.
That's unfortunate. Zavatskis with excellent defense in shutting off the baseline from Brown, but he doesn't get any weak side help. Again, little things in crunch time, and these last 6 minutes or so can be considered crunch time. You've got to be able to execute.
You can see from that shot, Griffin at the top of the zone, tired. Zavatskis at three! I think Syracuse's going to take a timeout here. This is the point in the games where their bench and their legs start to go a little bit, and they need to buy some time. And Pittsburgh may be getting the juice to make their push. And Syracuse has changed from a 32 to a full timeout.
Well, again, you take a look right here. Zavatskis just wide open. Syracuse uncharacteristically slow coming out on the wing. And look at Alan Griffin. I mean, he can barely get his hands up right now. And you got to feel for him again. Literally every minute but a few in this tournament he has played.
And if you were not with us for the quarterfinal last night, right about this point in the game, the 7 minute mark, as has become a pattern the last 3 or 4 games, timeout taken by Boeheim when there's an official timeout at the next dead ball to try to maximize the rest of the players in this stretch for the run. Steve Perfume and John Anderson will join us for SportsCenter. Number one seeds have become a question. How much of an impact do the conference tournaments have? We'll find out with Michigan State and Iowa State losing today, plus the NBA and Doug Flutie news as well.
has moved on to the championship game with a victory over Seton Hall, 75-48. The Eagles on a 33-6 run to close the game will make their third appearance in the title game. Pittsburgh has never been there. And as we said, Alan Griffin's been on the floor for every second of this tournament and every second of the last seven games, save 10 seconds on senior night at the Dome against Pittsburgh when he came out for applause and walk-ons. Jim Burr has a call underneath on Johnson of Pittsburgh. And Damone Brown will shoot 1-1. 17 fouls on Pittsburgh.
Now this has got to be a time for Pittsburgh. We talked about them running on emotion. Even Ricardo Greer, if you take a look at Preston Shumpert, you can't bear to watch this thing without him being involved. Even Ricardo Greer hasn't shown that same bounce, that same high emotion, high energy that you normally expect of him. He's been relatively quiet and undemonstrative.
Brown missed the second, and it's a big miss because that's the impact they were hoping for. Get the quick timeout from the official timeout after the called minute timeout. It didn't double up as Brown missed the back end of the 1-1. Inside of 6 minutes now.
Let's see if Brandon Knight recognizes that the two players at the top have kind of widened a little bit. A little ball movement will open it up for his penetration again.
Page, wide open three. Brown went up and got the rebound. Greer hit the deck. 5-on-4. Williams three. Seal it foul. And Zavatskis went sprawling. Syracuse's 15th foul and an official timeout. 5:34. Pittsburgh that close to their first ever appearance in the Big East Championship. They're tired, and they're blowing out tires, too.
Every day, you ask questions about life on Long Island. Will development in your neighborhood bring more pollution and congestion? Will your taxes be going up or down? Are your schools up to the challenges ahead? Look for the answers you need every day in Newsday. Newsday, it's where you live.
This Sunday, avoiding college financial aid scams, Suffolk County's $40 million sales tax deficit, and the Big East Finals. Get Newsday this weekend.
Where's Mike?
Still downloading. Hey, where's Mike? Still downloading. Yo, let's go.
Get better internet with Optimum Online. Try it free for 30 days. Call up, log on, stop by. What are you waiting for?
Some gonna get you. Some gonna grab you. Keep on running.
Oh, my goodness.
Keep on running from my life.
NCAA Women's Basketball Championship. Coverage begins March 16th on ESPN and ESPN2.
The famous roof atop the world's most famous arena. A view from the catwalk of Madison Square Garden. I've seen a million games in here. Never seen a view from up there. It's a neat shot. 18 Big East tournaments in this building. 18 of the 21 and a long-term extension. A new contract signed. The Big East tournament will be here the next 10 years as well. Pittsburgh's been here often, but never to the championship game. And they've got the opportunity tailor-made for them. Approaching five, leading by five, and first-team performer and the best scorer on the opposition outs for the game with a corneal abrasion. Preston Shumpert injured late first half.
Once again, watch Ricky Greer along that back baseline. A lot of attention being given to him by Brown, Selick, and Dwayne.
Knight with three to shoot. Griffin went up, and his hands freed it up for Selick.
Interestingly enough, Preston Shumpert, the best jump shooter on that team, obviously on the bench. I'm surprised that Pittsburgh hasn't gone to a zone for longer stretches of time to force guys like Griffin and Williams to shoot from outside.
Shumpert scored 31 against Connecticut and 14 in Syracuse's second round win over Providence by one, 55-54. And a team that's been gritty all year is being tested. Dwayne is short on every one of his shots here in the second half.
Now it's a good example of Pittsburgh trying to take care of the little things. Good block out on the free throw. They're going to be reminded every time play stops, every time out.
Brandon Knight, the sophomore. Jerron Brown, the freshman. Three-guard rotation of a freshman, a redshirt freshman, and a sophomore. And they've been very good this week. Knight lost it off Syracuse.
Well, if it wasn't, you talk about a poker face right there. Brandon Knight not giving away any hints.
Tend to shoot, as you see. Brown, that tough place to trigger. The trap comes. 3 for 3 is Greer. We have seen a whole mess of shots rim out in both games tonight. Damone Brown watched by Isaac Hawkins. Spins him through the lane. Rebound Hawkins, foul on Brown.
Well, before his injury last year, which caused him to miss most, if not all, of the season, Isaac Hawkins was among the best rebounders in the Big East, and we had an opportunity to see why. He's got great explosiveness in those legs, very athletic, and he just likes to do it.
Final official timeout, under 4 minutes. Pittsburgh leads 5-5. Syracuse have any drops of energy left in them.
Infinite possibilities, kind of like when you first got the internet. But now, slow logons and disconnects are really holding you back. Free yourself with the AT&T 7-7 offer and get unlimited internet access and long distance together. Only $7 a month gives you AT&T WorldNet service with the fastest logon times and better connections, plus 7 cents a minute long distance all day, every day. Call now for the AT&T 7-7 offer.
Welcome to the 7-Up Blind Taste Test. Go ahead, try the other one.
This is rancid milk, man. What is that, dishwater?
Yes, it is. Next. Not as refreshing as 7-Up, is it?
One left, one right.
You're sick, man.
Fresh squeezed this morning. See? 7-Up tastes better. Ah, it's like shooting fish in a barrel. Next.
Dan Patrick at TGI Fridays. Can I have your autograph, please?
Sure, bye.
Thanks, Mr. Patrick.
Don't mention it.
ESPN's presentation of the AT&T Big East Tournament is presented by AT&T. Get the AT&T 7-7 offer for unlimited internet service and long distance together. And in part by 7-Up and your local 7-Up bottler. Make 7-Up yours. And by Jordan.
Times Square bustling on a Friday night. Inside the Garden, Pittsburgh leads by 5. Very close to getting it done on a third straight night. Knocked off Miami and then pulled one of the bigger surprises in the history of this tournament, knocking off number one seed from the West, Notre Dame. And now they're that close.
Well, here's where you crank it up if you're Pittsburgh. You try to move the ball, make the defense move, get them tired. Then you got to crash the offensive glass in the event that you miss. You got to utilize every bit of energy that you have and squeeze it out of Syracuse.
Baseline Greer, 5 to shoot. Tried a nifty pass. Brown sees the shot clock, shoots a 3. Rebound Griffin.
Well, they got one of those right, and that was to work the clock as much as they could.
Contact. Griffin went down. No call. Williams finds Damone Brown. Brandon Knight tied up Griffin. He's hit the deck twice and is slow to get up. Williams 3.
It's like holding on by a fingernail. It's that slim a margin between Syracuse losing possession and making that three. And that's what they want to do. Just hold on. Get some breaks.
They've got confidence late in game. Nine to shoot. Zavatskis a three. Rebound Griffin. Damone Brown. Out to the point guard. Griffin the crossover. Off the glass and good. Timeout Pittsburgh.
There was a turning point. It was the play before where they just eked out possession to get the three. Now Alan Griffin with newfound energy. It's within their grasp, and it's the senior that's leading them. No, Jim Boeheim hasn't eaten too much. He's calling for a foul.
Nice pitches, guys. Kim Duffin, Chip Dean leading our great crew here in New York. I've seen every Syracuse team for the last 17 years, and there have certainly been more talented teams. Not that this team's not talented. They've got talented players. I have never seen a group that is tougher or guttier. And situations like this was a 34-cent stamp at halftime. You're playing your third game in 3 days. A double overtime game on Sunday. The travel trouble's getting down here that Dave talked about. Shumpert's out. He mailed this in. You know, their NCAA seed wouldn't be affected by what happened in this game, especially with Shumpert. You could have mailed this one in. These guys don't like to lose. And nobody likes to lose, but these guys just tighten up and get tougher in these situations.
But sometimes you can't really help it. When you get tired, everyone begins to feel sorry for themselves. It's a natural reaction. And it takes a play. It takes an effort by someone else that energizes you. And as we saw on the three by Deshaun Williams, the grapple for the ball and the possession for Syracuse may have been that elixir that's gotten them started. And, of course, Alan Griffin, the senior, sees it and brought his team to this point.
12 to shoot. Defense more aggressive. Zavatskis outside. Here's Greer, their best player, in their big moment. Gets close. Can't get it to go. The rebound, Hawkins!
Talk about a senior moment. That's what we have.
Pittsburgh by
Let's
two.
Go Let's go
Seniors from both teams now stepping up.
Let's go Let's go
Griffin, another drive, another take. No basket, no basket. Foul called on the floor before the shot.
Well, we extol the virtue of Alan Griffin and his experience and his will. Take a look at Isaac Hawkins. He's not going to be moved from that spot. Again, determination, particularly on the offensive glass. That's what gets you that type of success.
First free throw of the night for Griffin. One more coming. Boeheim and Syracuse trying to get to the title game. Get win 600 for Jim. On the other side for Pittsburgh, Ben Howland trying to get his team within 40 minutes of the automatic bid. And 50-50, minutes out.
For young people at home who wonder why coaches run them to death and then put them on the free throw line, this is why. When you're fatigued, you've got to be able to make those free throws.
What are you made of, Pittsburgh? Here's your moment. Knight lost it. Brown took it away. Second straight night, Deshaun Williams half-court defense. Timeout Syracuse. 10 seconds difference, game and shot clock.
I think this is more to give his team a blow, to get their minds settled, to get the legs a little bit rested, than to really talk strategy, because I can't see him doing anything but keeping the ball in Alan Griffin's hands and letting him do what he needs to do. Of course, Pittsburgh has got to talk about the defense right now. You take a look here. Brandon Knight gets himself in trouble. Good hands by Deshaun Williams. He had a terrific and timely steal yesterday with a strip. So two nights in a row. And the calmest guy out there, as he should be, was Jim Boeheim.
Now he's seen a bunch of this. This is his 1,089th game as a player, assistant, or coach at Syracuse. His 1,010th straight game. He's never missed a game or a practice in his 28 years as a coach, whether head coach or assistant.
But watch Pittsburgh step out on the screen. Got to help on the penetration.
Williams. So Vox just came up defensively again. And the loose ball goes to Pitt. No, Syracuse. I saw Donato come out and point. He was pointing towards Jim Burr for the call, for help on the call.
And that may have thrown both teams off, gave them a false sense of elation and disappointment at one time.
Let's see if he's timeout. Out. Each team has one.
There's the drive right here by Williams. Zavatskis comes up nicely right before the little dotted line where you have to stop the penetration before they get all the way in. And there's the attempt at the rebound. Everybody involved in that. There's no keeping a guy back in case of a fast break.
The Syracuse assistants were asking if it hit the rim on the shot. The officials, Higgins and Burr, conferred right away, and both were pretty confident that it did not hit the rim. And Bob Donato concurs. And as you saw in the replay, the officials were exactly right. Possession arrow, Syracuse. A Pitt foul is two Syracuse free throws. Cannot run the baseline on the inbound.
And a 10-second differential on the shot clock from regulation. Which means that Pittsburgh can play tight defense and still get an opportunity.
In the hands of the senior Griffin.
See, I got to double him. I got to get the ball out of his hand. Make somebody else beat me.
The free throw line, he's waiting for help.
There it is. There's the double.
He's open. The pass is towards Sealick. Knocked away. Deshaun Williams goes. The clock is running down. The rebound, Pittsburgh. The Panthers have a chance. Here is Knight with 5 seconds. Zavatskis handling out here. To Knight in the air. No good. Griffin rebound. Overtime.
Well, if strategy was apparent, you have to get the ball out of Alan Griffin's hands. Pittsburgh did it. Brandon Knight tried for the layup, recognized he still had time, but it didn't have numbers. That's why he kicked it back outside, but again, didn't wind up with the shot he wanted.
Greer was dying to touch it. Just what these teams need after three straight games. Five more. Throw it out for coming back.
Infinite possibilities. Kind of like when you first got the internet. But now, slow logons and disconnects are really holding you back. Free yourself with the AT&T 7-7 offer and get unlimited internet access and long distance together. Only $7 a month gives you AT&T WorldNet service with the fastest logon times and better connections. Plus 7 cents a minute long distance all day, every day. Call now for the AT&T 7-7 offer.
I can get
more masking tape,
more concrete,
more plaster,
more of these.
I'll need more tools,
more lawn,
more of this.
Hey neighbor,
more of that.
Maybe I can get 3 more feet.
I need a lot more tools.
When I go to Home Depot, I can save money,
nuts,
and I can get more stuff.
A lot more than I would have expected.
That's what I'm talking about.
This is why I go to Home Depot first.
The Home Depot, first in home improvement.
We go to overtime. Sports Center to follow.
see. Back at noon, the ACC afternoon quarterfinal went on. And with the overtime game in the Patriot League, we've been going for 11 straight hours here on ESPN with basketball, not counting the games on ESPN2. Another game at midnight. How much fun is championship week? Knights saved it. Add a timeout for each team, so both have two here in the extra session. Again, two headlines. Syracuse best player, Preston Shumpert. Corneal abrasion, late first half, out the whole second half. Pittsburgh's never been to the Big East Championship game. Zavotsky misfired. Both teams have played three games in three nights. And now add 5 minutes of overtime to it.
Both teams right now are playing on fumes. This is nothing but emotion right now.
Ground push on the baseline drive. It's two free throws. Let's go back to the end of regulation, Len.
Well, you take a look right there, mentally drained. Look at Alan Griffin. Just wants to lay that head back, pull some air into those lungs, and go at it again. But I'll tell you what, on this play, good recognition by a veteran team, knowing that both teams are tired. The explosive move is the one that's going to result in a foul. You can't settle for jump shots at this point in the game. Brown makes his explosive move. He gets to the free throw line. Pittsburgh's going to have to follow suit.
Brown has missed four free throws tonight, and he's a 79% shooter. It is correct when he add his Big East tournament performance to his 79.4 in the regular season. And Shumpert with that corneal abrasion watches his teammates take the lead at 51-50. Greer finds Hawkins, who got it tonight but was fouled first. It's the seventh Syracuse foul, so it will be 1-1. Ricardo Greer gets a touch in overtime. This was the end of regulation.
But he should have come here and replaced Zavotkis instead of waiting there. Zavotkis really caught between no man's land. Felix stepped out and blocked his vision of Greer. Greer should have replaced Zavotkis as soon as Brandon Knight made his push to the basket. That way he'd be seen and be assured of getting that last shot.
For Hawkins, who was 4-4 from the line tonight, but just a 52% shooter on the season. Felix sets the pick on Jerron Brown. Only point of overtime for Syracuse. Griffin lost it. Trying to foul Greer. Can't catch up to him. Greer couldn't connect. Brown gets fouled. If it's Dwayne, it's five.
And look at Ben Howland screaming for the foul. The initial foul on Ricardo Greer.
It's Deshaun Williams charged with the foul.
Take a look right here. Griffin gets a little out of control. Greer gets it. He was fouled once. That time he missed. And good call by the officials.
Two free throws for Jerron Brown. Honorable mention McDonald's All-American in high school.
Okay.
As someone once said, no words, just pictures.
And that's the best one.
It's better to be lucky than good.
He has 4 years of eligibility left, a partial qualifier last year, did practice with the team. Long on the second one. Perhaps he'd say not long enough. 90 seconds, a free throw apiece. And Sports Center follows with John Anderson and Steve Berthiaume. The EAS Mountain West semifinal, Utah, New Mexico at the top of the hour. Griffin three.
He's hit some big ones before, hasn't he?
He has 19. There's a pedigree of great point guards at Syracuse, and same thing, not the best, but top of the list in terms of gutty guys. And speaks to seniors at this time of the year. knows just how to summon up the extra little something. Knight spinning. The location for Greer. Seniors this time of year just know how to summon up that little something. Greer has a dozen. Williams on the take. Hawkins the rebound for the Panthers.
Didn't have enough to finish. Deshaun Williams got there in good shape. But didn't have the strength to get the ball up there.
See where Greer ends up here. What can they do against the zone? Carter runs baseline. He's now near side. He has it. He strikes it. Rebound, Brandon Knight. And this will take us under the two-minute mark. Again, each team, a couple of timeouts.
And once again, you look at how tight Williams and Griffin are at the top of that 2-3. They're not going to allow Brandon Knight to penetrate through that middle and also try to squeeze the guy at the top. That's why Rhea's trying to set the pick to free his guard.
Time to shoot. Not much going on. Very stagnant. Brown tries to drive. The foul on Deshaun Williams. It will be his fourth.
His foul is on Deshaun Williams. That's his fourth.
You take a look right here. Deshaun Williams allowed to penetrate beyond the free throw line, pulling back the defense, and he finds Alan Griffin. And here, Knight, boy, just lucky to get that out of there. And Ricardo Greer doing what he's been doing throughout this series, hitting the big ones.
Is put up three, four free throws.
And you know what Ricardo Greer's telling him? Hey, man, take the shot. If you miss it, we'll get it back.
LSU leading. Maryland up big. Watch out for the Terps this weekend in Atlanta. They fight for it. Official goes down. The bench goes down. It is, I think, Syracuse ball. Let's see. Jim Burr's coming out to talk with Bob Donato as they clear up the four players who were cleared out on the end of the bench over there. Everybody's gotten up okay. And Burr and Donato, after the conversation, say it's Syracuse ball. And there's no arguments from the Pittsburgh side. Watch the effort here. Hawkins.
Well, Hawkins obviously carried the ball out of bounds, so the call is there. There may have been a question of whether it's a foul or not. And at this point in the game, you're not going to get that call.
The steal by Brandon Knight. Ben Howland called one set play, then said, no, let's change it. And then said, well, if I can't decide, I can't expect you guys to execute. Let me take a timeout. Sports Center as soon as we're done. But you know what? We may not be done for a while. With 1:10 left, Syracuse and Pittsburgh all even at 54 apiece. Again, a reminder that the winner gets Boston College in tomorrow night's championship game. And here's Dave Ryan.
Well, Mike and Len, we talked about toughness with Alan Griffin. The numbers now are mind-boggling. This is his third total overtime in the past seven games. It's 302 minutes, 50 seconds out of a possible 303 minutes of action for Alan Griffin. He's staying on the court somehow, keeping out there for the Orangemen, despite the cramps he's undergone over the past 24 hours as well. Just incredible to watch.
And Dave, as we pointed out earlier, he has been on the floor for the entire Big East tournament. Now would be 124 minutes. There are the Eagles, who are just sitting back, probably back at the hotel now. Saw some of the players earlier in here. Now they've left. It's fine. You guys beat yourselves up. Somebody's going to get to the championship game like Connecticut did last year and play a fourth game in 4 days. And the toll for the Huskies, Jim Calhoun said, with a year of reflection, was more mental than physical. And their championship game loss to a more rested St. John's team. I think here would be the other story for these teams that are not as deep.
But certainly Syracuse is feeling the effects. Not only do they lose Preston Shumpert, their leading scorer, but as you mentioned, you know, they've got some guys out there that have been called upon to carry a load far greater than they've had to do throughout the season. And the question is whether they strain under the load. At this point in time, you look at guys like Griffin, Williams, and Brown. And they seem to be ready for battle right now, at least for another minute and 10.
On the Syracuse side, when you're in a fight like this, you want to win. Bigger picture heading towards next week in the NCAAs, how much energy will they expend here? On the Pittsburgh side, this is their chance to get in the NCAA tournament. Zavatskis, three, rimmed out again.
But you got to keep taking them. If that presents itself again, you got to put it up. Once again, you can't let Griffin beat you. Widen him out with the hedge on the picks, as Zavatskis just did. And once again with Williams, same thing. Keep him flat, east-west, not north-south.
15 to shoot. Shot clock will be off after this trip. Griffin turned away. Seal it from the top of the key. Hawkins rebound. Clock is off. Pittsburgh calls a set play. I think they're going to keep it on the floor.
Lest anybody get upset, Billy Seelick had to take that shot. Couldn't get a better one.
They're going to take a timeout.
You know, Jim Boeheim is talking to him right now and wondering, why did you take it? But quite honestly, if you can hit a free throw, you should be able to hit that shot. He had absolutely no one on him.
That's all that was left. You know, you talk about the big power conferences, and a lot of people say they only play a tournament for monetary reasons. Well, there are opportunities for teams. And in this year, this Big East, where there's no power team, the opportunity was here for Seton Hall. They couldn't cash in, but it's here for Pittsburgh now. They can get to the NCAA tournament, and we see it rarely. Arkansas last year, NC State a few years ago in the ACC tournament, went three games and played a great fourth game. They couldn't get over the hump. But this is Pittsburgh's chance to catch a fire, and they got it at the end of the season against weaker opponents. And now here's the moment. I keep bringing it up, but this is what the conference tournament week is all about. Their star is Greer. He's in the corner of the bottom of the screen. Knight dribbles. Inside, and a foul is called on Hawkins. Hawkins will shoot the free throws. And there will be two free throws coming because it's the 10th foul on Syracuse.
Well, certainly Jim Boeheim didn't want his defense to allow the ball to get to that point. Again, off of penetration. But he certainly instructed his guys, no layups. Make them earn it.
Pittsburgh, one of five with free throws in the overtime. Hawkins has been good. Two free throws. Tie game. One free throw. Tie game. Timeout Syracuse. It has one more remaining. Pittsburgh knows. Chance to remind you that Pittsburgh is trying to find a way to get this one, get one more against Boston College tomorrow night, and be a part of the field of 65 when we give you the men's selection special for 90 minutes at 6:30 Eastern and break down the brackets even further on College Hoops tonight on ESPN2. And don't forget, the NCAA Women's Selection Special, the exclusive announcement of the Field of 64, presented by State Farm at 5 Eastern. And before that, the Big 12 and ACC title games. The group that's in included a Pittsburgh tie with Holy Cross, former Panther coach Ralph Willard, in an overtime rally in Worcester, Massachusetts, knocking out Navy.
I'll tell you, that timeout called by Jim Boeheim had obvious reasoning behind it. One, obviously, to see what they're going to do in the event of a miss, and also to give his guys a blow, but it also may have helped Pittsburgh in that now, if there is a miss, they're focused on getting back to their men.
Hawkins hit it. Jerron Brown comes in for defense. One stop, and the Panthers are one game away.
Good substitution by Ben Howland. Stops the clock, allows his defense to get set.
Sean Williams can run the baseline. Syracuse is going to take its final timeout. Sports SportsCenter's coming up with Steve Berthiaume and John Anderson. This has been a wonderful day of college basketball. Look up at the board, and George Washington is beating Temple. A wild Atlantic 10 tournament in Philadelphia. UMass knocked out St. Joe's, and both Philly teams might go down in Philly. And we had losses by top 10 teams like Iowa State and Michigan State that will affect the seeding process. The guys will have it all for you, and at midnight Eastern, take you out to Las Vegas for the Mountain West semi between New Mexico and the top seed Utah.
Well, here's the controversy right now, at least in the coaching circles. Do you man this thing or do you zone it? Because obviously it's going to be a long pass. They run the play, home run, try to get the ball to the opposite free throw line. Do you play men or do you go to the ball? If you're going to the ball, then you may want to play a zone or at least have some of your guys play in a zone and just go after the ball like a cornerback would go after a pass in a Hail Mary.
They just tried to sub in Chad Johnson, could not. Deshaun Williams can run the baseline after the made free throw.
The key also is John Brown has got to keep Griffin in front of him. Don't let him get behind.
The screen so Williams can throw the long pass to the long arm Brown. It's knocked away, and the Panthers, no, it's Syracuse ball, and time has run out. The Panthers will see another day. For the first time in school history, Pittsburgh will play in the championship game. The monster play of the game. Isaac Hawkins game-winning free throw after his team was 1 of 6 in the overtime shooting free throws. Pittsburgh only the second team with a losing conference record to make the Big East tournament final. And for the first time since the Big East has gotten an automatic bid in the NCAAs, a team will play in the championship game knowing their only way into the field in the NCAA tournament is to win here. Dave Ryan with Ben Hamilton and Brendan Knight.
All right, Mike, thanks. Very happy Pittsburgh Panthers here. 19th Big East tournament. The first time Pittsburgh makes it to the Big East championship game. What does that mean to your program?
All right, I'm really proud of our players. You know, we missed some open shots. Normally we whack down, but we hung in there. We never hung our head, and that's been this team all year. They've been resilient. We've had some tough periods. We won 6 of our last 7 now. We have a lot of confidence right now going into this final game, and a lot of it has to do with my man right here who's leading the way for us, Brandon Knight. Did an outstanding job being the floor general for us.
Emotional game tonight. Talk to me about Boston College and the championship.
Boston College is a great team. You know, they're 9 or 10 in the country, whatever it is. They've got a big-time player in Troy Bell. We have nothing but great respect for them. You know, we've got to get back to the office here right now at the hotel and get to work because we have not played them this year. That's one of the 3 teams we haven't seen. We haven't seen Villanova, Boston College, or St. John's. We have a lot of work to do in preparation.
Coach, congratulations. See you tomorrow night. Okay, here's Brandon Knight. Unbelievable finish for you. This goes into one of the all-time great dramatic finishes for a team. Didn't look like you'd be able to do this well in the tournament. Preston Shumpert out in the second half. How big a key was that for your team?
We knew we could help a little bit more away from the ball, help on DeMone some, and help on that penetration from Allen Griffin.
You guys have been busy. 3 games, 3 nights. Now you got one more. Any gas left in the tank?
Yeah, we got some gas left. No one expected us to be here, but we're just trying to prove everyone wrong.
Tell us about Boston College. You haven't faced them yet this year. How about a preview?
I don't know what to expect. I haven't seen them play that much this year, but we're going to get together tonight, and hopefully we're going to put together a game plan as well as the one tonight.
See you tomorrow. Good luck.
Thanks.
Mike.
Thank you, Dave. Championship week in the month of March is about Cinderella. The slipper in the Big East is blue and gold for the Pittsburgh Panthers. We'll see you tomorrow night to see if Pittsburgh can get the automatic bid out of the Big East. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. After 11 hours and 23 minutes of championship week hoops, SportsCenter takes us to the Mountain West game at midnight. From Len and Dave, Mike Tirico. See you tomorrow night.